Hello guys, welcome to my channel No DevOps. So today I am showing you how to create Lambda function in AWS using the Terraform. So before that, I suppose the guys if you are watching my channel, you have understanding of AWS Lambda function and also Terraform code. Terraform code is basically a software to run application over the cloud using the serverless architecture. So before starting, please have a look below this URL and open my channel and subscribe it to keep updated with the latest and upcoming videos. So this video is an example of running a serverless application on AWS Cloud. So for this video, I am using the Python code and deploying the Python code in Lambda function using the Terraform. So before creating the Lambda function using the Terraform, there are two prerequisites that has to be done before going ahead. First is, in your Linux box, install AWS CLI and configure it. Configure it means you have to provide the access key, secret key, and the region where you are going to create your Lambda function. And second is, install Terraform CLI. So in this video, I'm not going to showing you how to create AWS access key and secret key, how to install AWS CLI, and how to configure AWS CLI. We will create the Terraform manifestation files, or basically the required necessary files to create your resources, in this case Lambda, and execute the Terraform manifest files and create the resources and then final validation. So I am presuming that you have installed AWS CLI and configure in your Linux box and also install the Terraform CLI. So here in Terraform code, I am using basically four code blocks. I will create a variables.tf, then output.tf, main.tf and Python code. So Python code is the have extension of py, and all the Terraform code blocks, or you can say the manifest Terraform manifest files, have extension of .tf. So I am going to show you the Terraform manifest files here. So first file is variables.tf. So basically Terraform codes are written as configuration blocks and with an extension of .tf. So now I am going to show you these files. And it is very easy. It is easy if you may create separate file for separate purpose. So if you want to define the variables in Terraform, you should create a separate file. That is, here I have created variables.tf. Let's have a look on it. So for this code, this purpose, this video, I am just defining the AWS region. So I am giving the default region AP South 1. If you are creating your Lambda in another region, you can give the name of your region here. Then another file is that is called output.tf. So basically in output.tf, I am just showing the output has output will come, which will show the Terraform function created, and it's a name, and it's a basically ARN. Now the main file is that is main.tf. So this is the main file. So in main.tf basically there are many blocks of code blocks are there. So in this video I am showing you all the blocks in main.tf. But in next video I will show how to separate your all the blocks of main.tf into separate manifest files. So this is the basically code I will explaining. I am explaining you. First is the provider, AWS provider region, basically in which region your code will be created and deployed. So first is the provider region var dot AWS region. So this AWS region will be picked from the variable dot here where you have already defined the region name. So you can also separate out this code and give the name of provider dot tf, something like that. So this is you can say this is the provider block. Another is I am giving the archive. This is the archive block. So basically this block is used to create a zip file of your source code. In this case it is Python, it may be Node.js or something and in any other language. But so basically this will create the source code, this will create the zip file of your source code and deploy it into Lambda. So basically if there are 2-3 files of Lambda function, it will be compressed into zip format and will be deployed on the Lambda. So basically here is archive file type is zip and source file name is welcome.py. You can give the path also if it is in separate folder, and the output path basically the zip file that will be created. I am giving the welcome.zip. Now next block is AWS IAM policy document. So basically this is the JSON which will basically it creates the IAM policy document as a JSON which is used to create an IAM policy. So it is simple JSON file which you give in when you create the IAM policy in IAM using the console. So here I am given the just a simple JSON state effect principal Lambda Amazon AWS.com type service action assume role. Now next is resource. I creating the IAM role using that policy. So we are going to basically I am going to use the JSON output of the preceding data block of IAM policy document. So I am giving the name of IAM for Lambda and assume role policy name is data dot this is the name AWS IAM policy document, then policy, this is the policy, then JSON dot JSON. So basically in this block we are referring to the output of the that document. And the last is resource Lambda function. So in this basically this block will create the Lambda function. So I am giving the function name that is welcome. You can give your name as per your wish. Then file name, that is the file name will be picked from the data archive, file zip output underscore path you have defined here. This is the file name. Then source code has, so basically the output is encrypted using base64. Then here you are defining the role that will come from AWS IAM role from lambda.arn from here. Then handler welcome.lambda-handler at runtime basically you will give the version of Python you are going to use. So this is the the main.tf. So it has 3-4 blocks. So basically main blocks are, I am going to show you, is the provider block, archive block, IAM policy document JSON, IAM policy using JSON, and AWS Lambda function block. Just again, I am explaining provider block, here you define the provider, archive block, where you compress the your source code. Then you will create the JSON, IAM policy JSON, and then create the policy using that JSON. And last one is the AWS Lambda function block, where you define the details of the AWS Lambda function. Now, there is one more file that is called welcome.py. So this is the basically the Python code. This will create, I have just used this Python code that is just creating the random password. So this is basically I have taken from the any file Python code just for testing purpose from the, you can search in the Google and you can take it. I'm not going to explain the Python code here. So just running the code. First, just run the Terraform init. After that, Terraform plan, that will show you what output is going to do, but that will show you the output which you are going to create in your AWS Lambda. Here you can see that what you have defined, it is showing the correct values, it is picking the correct values or not. After that, Terraform apply. Just press type enter and press yes. So it is showing some error. Let me check it. So it is showing that Python 3.6 is not supported. You have to change the runtime Python. Okay, let me change it. Go to here, go to the bottom. Then again, you have to init it. Terraform plan. Then Terraform apply. Okay, now you have see, you can see that it has completed. Resolve one added, no change, no destroy. The output is, so it is giving the lambda function. Now you go to the console and check it. Now go to the lambda function and search the name of function you have created. So this is the code it is created. You can have a look on this. This is the code. Now you can see that your lambda function is created.